In the middle of Santa Monica's East End district of businesses and entertainment media complexes sits an enclave untouched by development since the mid-20th century. Village Trailer Park stands as a testament to an era of a new car nation when people towed their RVs and trailers to this beachside community for vacations and weekends at the beach. Over the decades, as Santa Monica evolved, so too did Village Trailer Park. It became a village of mobile homes serving the community with affordable low-income housing. With a total of 109 spaces on its near 4 acres lot, residents from all walks of life enjoyed living in this quiet and safe little neighborhood. Over the years, it became one of two remaining mobile home parks in Santa Monica. In 2006, the property was sold to a developer and the residents were served with eviction notices. City of Santa Monica's Rent Control Board interceded, informing the owners that a city charter required a removal permit before rent-controlled units were allowed to be removed or closed. Avoiding litigation, the owners decided to work with the city on a development agreement. As part of the negotiation with the city, the imminent eviction of the residents were put on hold. One hope for residents in recent months was to get landmark status declared for the park. ICF International, a Los Angeles-based firm, stated that VTP was, quote, a manifestation of the city's architectural, cultural, economic, and social history of the city of Santa Monica in the post-war era, and valuable to the study of the architectural history of the middle decades of the 20th century in Santa Monica, unquote. However, in early 2012, the city's Landmark Commission voted 5-2 against giving it landmark designation. Staff report from the city's Landmark Commission reported, quote, the trailer park's overall identity and history is heavily reliant on the presence of trailers, which are non-permanent fixtures upon the land and cannot be included in any designation in which are substantially reduced in numbers, unquote. That last point was particularly insulting to many of the residents who witnessed the destruction of homes as older residents passed away and management refused to accept new residents. There are now 50 or so remaining mobile homes and trailers on the property. Empty concrete pads are all that's left of these recently demolished homes. The current proposal for the residents includes Section 8 housing for those who are low income, although some retirees receiving pensions won't qualify. Another option is to move to a nearby mobile home park. This presents a challenge for many whose trailers and mobile homes are not in a condition to be moved. Many mobile homes are not, in fact, mobile. The third option would involve moving the remaining residents into apartments to be built on the development site. Many residents are not happy to give up their yards and homes, which they own, to move into an apartment unit. Older residents would have to give up the convenience of parking next to their mobile homes, and it isn't clear whether they'd be offered parking spaces along with their low-income apartment units. This option also means that residents would be displaced during the time the mobile home park is demolished and the new complexes are built. Facing the mounting challenge to save their village, residents have banded together, held meetings with the city's planning commission, and plan to file an appeal with the city council to overturn the Landmark Commission's decision. Some have tired of the fight and have moved on. But most residents remain steadfast in their hope of saving their homes and this little piece of Santa Monica history.
My name is Calvin Normore. I'm a university teacher, a professor of philosophy at UCLA, and I've been here 14 years, since 1998. First of all, it's not a trailer park in the sense in which, at least I grew up expecting to find trailer parks. I don't think there's been a unit moved out of here on its own two wheels, so to speak, in the whole time that I've been here. Most of these units were put here in the 50s. Some have been added. And they've just stayed here. And the park, in a sense, has grown up around them. I think originally the park was built as a recreational vehicle park, and perhaps it was also used by workers from the McDonnell Douglas aircraft plant that was here. But by the time I had arrived, at any rate, it was very much a community of people who were living here, whose lives were here. And it was each of these units, mobile homes and smaller things, was nestled essentially among trees and gardens. It had the feel of a village, and to some extent it still does. I mean, there's been a lot of harm done to it over the last decade, but to some extent it still does. And one of the curious features of this kind of living is because you have your own private space, but there's outside space around it, people tend to spend a reasonable amount of time outdoors. And of course, in California, you can do that easily. And so people meet each other quite ordinarily and casually in the ordinary sort of business, in a way that you wouldn't in an apartment. And so we get to know each other and become, to the extent that anyone wants to become, involved in each other's lives. The park, I think perhaps all of California mobile home parks are required to. I'm not sure, but anyway, this park's got a pool, and because it has a pool, there can be life around the pool, and it's great for me because I have two boys who love to swim, and so it's fantastic for them. So, I mean, what's not at all obvious now is that Santa Monica was a beach community quite far from L.A. If you look at the movie Mildred Pierce, or read the book, then the anti-heroine of that movie runs away from Glendale to Santa Monica, right, to live the wild life. Now, if you drive now from Glendale to Santa Monica, it just seems like one unbroken city. It would be, it seems unthinkable that one could think that this was running away. But in the 30s and 20s and 40s even, right up until the Great Highways building of the mid-50s, Santa Monica was a very, very different from Los Angeles, and it had the feel of a beach community. So these trailer parks, of which there were many, I think there were still 14 of them, even just 15 or 20 years ago, these were partly vacation places for people and partly places for low-income housing, particularly low-income housing for the workers who would come here to work in the aircraft industry during the war. And so they formed, I guess now there are just the two of us left, the two parks left, they formed a central part of the development of Santa Monica. I mean, so Santa Monica went from being a playground for the rich to a place where ordinary people could afford to come for vacation or to work and live, to now being essentially a sort of suburb of Los Angeles. So these parks mark that intervening period in the history of Santa Monica, which is probably the most important period, actually, in the history of the city. We never thought that the case before the Landmark Commission was the only or most central thing that we can do here. It's really the political will of Santa Monica more than anything else, probably, that'll determine the fate of this park. But the Landmark Commission, what it decided was that it couldn't do it because the crucial things that would have to be landmarked were the actual mobile homes and trailers themselves, because they were the things that go back into the 40s, 50s, and 60s. And it decided that since those were mobile, they couldn't be landmarked, right? They weren't, so to speak, marks of the land, but something else. I myself think this was a mistake on their part, because in fact, the only way almost any unit can be taken out of this park is by destroying it. I mean, I don't think there's been one that's been moved easily in a great while, and certainly the ones that would justify the landmarking, the ones from the 50s and 60s, it's very unclear whether they could ever move again. I think it's almost certain that they couldn't. So we're going to appeal this decision. There is precedent for this appeal. I was talking with an art historian I know in Indiana the other day, who told me that there were actually several cases where mobile home parks had been landmarked. So there is precedent, and we have hope that it will that the appeal will be heard. But if it's refused, and who can tell? Then of course we still have to very much continue the struggle in the city, and in the end, as I said, this will be decided at City Council in all probability.